Welcome to the Nevis Newscast for Thursday, July 4th, 2019. I'm Fredicia Liebert. A new generation, discipline and manners, a bridge between goals and accomplishments, was the theme for the 2019 graduation and prize-giving ceremony for the Violet O. Jeffers Nichols Primary School, held under the patronage of Mr. and Mrs. Glenn Joseph. Past student of the school, Mickey Mills, in delivering the feature address, gave some encouraging words to the graduates.
No matter how tired you may be, no matter how filled you may think that your brain is with your notes, no matter how many times you've read over your notes, no matter how early your parents wake you up at mornings, no matter how much you believe that you are done, that you are out for the count, you are not. You must exercise discipline. You must be optimistic. And in applying those two things, you will be able to achieve your goals and accomplishments.
Top student for test of standard at the school is Sasha Brown. Brown was named valedictorian and received the Premier Award, the Violet Nichols Award for Top Girl, the Mount Lily Church of Christ Award, the Nisbet Plantation Beach Club Award for first place, the Juletta Jeffers Award for first in mathematics, among other awards.
Let us use the words of our theme today, discipline and manners, as our mantra, as we take our first steps into accomplishing our goals in high school. We have made it thus far through determination and hard work. We have shared uncountable memories that will last a lifetime. To conclude, I want to leave you with this verse from Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Special mention must be made of Jadiel Joseph. Joseph received the Premier and Violet Nichols Award for Top Boy at the Violet Chapman Award, among other awards. Sasha Brown, Adonijah Hendrickson, Damian Modesto, Tanissa Pemberton, Talia Phillip, Delisha Walwin, Kiel Wallace, Jadiel Joseph, Stedari Pemberton, Adian Nisbet, and Dewani Hicks received their certificates, awards, and prizes by the patrons, Mr. and Mrs. Glenn Joseph. The ceremony took place at the Cumbermere Methodist Church and was chaired by past student Kalia Clark.
That journey to the final test of standards was not easy, but we have made it. Our experiences at the Joycelyn Liebert Primary School would not have been complete without our heats and sports day events leading up to the much anticipated inter-primary championships, cricket matches against our fellow primary schools, field trips to historical sites including Brimstone Hill and other attractions, dances and performances for our Christmas Black History Month concert and school anniversary concerts, learning Chinese for Library Month, being the champions of the tourism quiz, computer quiz, maths quiz, and most recently waking up the worshippers at the Fenton Hill Church of God with our melodious renditions. We, the 2019 graduating class of the Joycelyn Liebert Primary School, are a powerhouse of innovation and creativity. As we set our future goals, we will endeavor to achieve them.
Valedictorian of the Joycelyn Liebert Primary School, Shama Otley, speaking at the graduation and prize-giving ceremony of the Joycelyn Liebert Primary School, held on Wednesday, July 3rd at the St. George's Anglican Church. Otley received the Violet O. Nichols Award for Outstanding Performance in Language Arts, the Development Bank and Mrs. Elvina Mulcair Award for Outstanding Performance in Social Studies, among other awards. Special mention must be made of Top Boy on the Island for Test of Standards, Rajon Fifield. Fifield received the Honorable Eric Eden Award for Good Work in Mathematics, the Lundy Esdale Award for Best Language Arts and Mathematics Results in Test of Standards, the Prentice Brooks Award for Best Combined Mathematics and Science Results, among other awards. past teacher of Gingerland Primary School, now the Joycelyn Lybert Primary School, Leonard Stapleton, delivered the feature address. He spoke on the day's theme, Mindset Matters. You are what you choose to be.
You are really a combination of the qualities that you are born with, your talents, the attitudes and values that you develop. When you add that together, you actually get the formula for your mindset. Because you can have talent, but if you don't have the proper attitude and values, that talent could be very dangerous, and sometimes it's laid to rest. You die and people don't even realize you had that talent. Your mindset determines your actions. Not just what you do, but how you do it and why you do it. Okay? You could have somebody who's an excellent dancer, somebody who's mediocre, but the mediocre dancer is giving it the passion, the awe, and the expert is just going through the motion. Who do you think the world would enjoy most?
The patrons of the ceremony were Mr. and Mrs. Casey Challenger. They distributed the certificates and prizes to the 23 graduates. The principal of the school, Barbara Hendrickson, delivered the principal's report. The chairperson of the event was past student Shadonte Longford. The ceremony was lined with a number of songs. Still to come, Nevis Mango and Food Festival officially opens. The details after this break.
At a loss as to what's going on in Nevis? Tune into NNC on MTV. Don't worry if you don't have cable either. NNC will bring the news to you wherever you are. Facebook and Facebook Live. YouTube and YouTube Live. NevisTVOnline.com. Roku app, NTV mobile app, Smart TV, Apple TV, and any other IPTV platforms. When me ANC and you ANC, NNC.
Welcome back. The Nevis Island Administration wishes to inform the general public of the following Household Assistance Program checks distribution schedule. Checks are now available for the June 2019 disbursement of the Poverty Alleviation Program and can be collected at the Department of Social Services from 9:30 a.m. to 3 p.m. daily. Please be reminded that a valid government-issued ID must be presented when collecting checks. Contact the Department of Social Services at 469-0720 or 469-5521, extension 2045. For the first time in the history of the Nevis Mango and Food Festival, chefs from other Caribbean islands will be participating in the various competitions.
Over the years, we've had the competition. The competition was mainly among restaurants here on the island of Nevis. And now we've expanded that because we recognize that there's tremendous, not only interest, but support coming from different islands of the Caribbean. We wanted to also give them a chance to participate and to enjoy some of the fun of the festival.
Chief Executive Officer of the Nevis Tourism Authority, Greg Phillip, was speaking during a live interview at the official opening of the Nevis Mango and Food Festival today, Thursday, July 4th, at Cleveland Gardens, located at Pinney's. Phillip also spoke about the objective of the festival in the presence of invited guests and chefs.
As we have an abundance of mangoes here on Nevis, and apart from the mangoes on Nevis, we have a great culinary scene, and it was our objective to find a creative way to combine those two. And the main reason why we wanted to create a festival like this during the summer was because this is really the summer season, and we needed something to keep Nevis relevant during the summer months and also to attract more people to Nevis during the summer months.
A number of events make up this year's festival, including a cooking mango masterclass. This is a practical session with an expert chef on cooking with mangoes. Registered persons will have a chance to eat what they cook. This will take place on Friday, July 5th at Cleveland Gardens at 10 a.m. In the evening of July 5th, a mango dinner will take place at Sunshine's Bar and Grill. On Saturday, July 6th at 10 a.m., a mango tasting session will take place at the Department of Agriculture's Kids Bay facility. Mango expert Ronald King from the Department of Agriculture will conduct mango tasting sessions. At 12 p.m. on July 6th, there will be a Nevis Village food tour around the island and at 6 p.m., a mango dinner will be hosted at Passion Bar and Grill in Cox Village. On July 7th, the final activity to bring down the curtains on the Nevis Mango and Food Festival 2019 will be the Nevisian Chef's Mango Feast. This event will begin at 12 p.m. at Wally Bay. A number of local mango dishes will be available at this event. Philip noted that a total of 16 chefs will participate in the Nevisian Chef's Mango Feast, double the amount from 2018. For more information about the festival and availability of tickets for the events, visit www.nevismangofest.com or visit the Nevis Tourism Authority. That's it for this edition of the Nevis Newscast. On behalf of all of us here at the Department of Information, I'm Felicia Liebert. Thank you for viewing.